So hello everyone, I did almost all the video of this algorithm and then I saw that it wasn't recorded, so just I'll rub this out. Okay, so now let's start. Hopefully it records this time. Okay, so first thing, if you love the video, please go and watch the full video. Okay, please subscribe to my channel so that you can get notification, and click the bell icon so that you can get notification when I upload. And please do subscribe to my channel. I don't ask generally, but if you love my channel, so if you love watching my videos, so even if one person is watching my videos, then it's also I'm happy with it. Okay, so just it gives a like a boost my expectation and confidence that some people are watching my video. So if I please do subscribe. So now moving on to the algorithm here. So let's see, we have to find max min. Okay, max and min of from an array. So first, max min a I j, max and min, these are the variables we have taken. So if I equals to j means then max is equals to mix, this is min is equal to a of I. Okay, so means what, there is one element and that is the max and that is the mean. So there is nothing to do, that max is equals to mean equals to that element. Now else if I is equals to j minus 1, and then so there are two elements, one is less than other. So we have to check, if a of I is less than a of j, then mean equals to a I, max equals to a j. So the a of I is less than a j means one element will be mean, the other will be max. So if this condition fails, so like a of I is greater than a of j, so it will be here, this else will point to here, this the opposite, vice versa, max will be a of I and mean will be a of j. So nothing to do about this, just when it is one element it will be max and it will be mean, when there are two elements it will be one will be the max and one will be the mean. We have to just compare the two elements. Now so now our next part is, if there are more than two elements, we have to find the mid element I plus j divide by 2. So finding mid element is like doing in binary search. We will do in depth in binary search, don't have to think much about it now. So now let's say if then we are calling the function again, this is recursive calling. Okay, so max mean a comma I mid max and mean, so it is running from I to mid. Okay, from the first recursive function is running from I to mid, and then recursive function is running from a mid plus 1, it is j, okay, not I, this is j. So mid plus 1 to j it is running, then max 1 and max mean 1. So these two variables are taken. If max of 1 is greater than max, then max equals to max 1. So you have to be very careful here with this greater than and less than sign. If mean of 1 is less than mean, then mean equals to mean 1. So this is our function calling, these two part is just calling the function, recursively calling the function again and again. Okay, so now time complexity. So now you can see all this takes just some constant time. Okay, and here it is taking t of n by 2, means total is n, it is divided into two parts, this the array is divided into two parts, so it will take time of n by 2. Okay, so this will take 1 and this will take 1. So why I am writing all this, because I will tell you why I am writing this. What we generally do, like t of n by 2, 2 times means 2 plus some constant, and we do the from with the help of Master's theorem mostly, or if Master's theorem is not applicable, then we do other substitution, iteration and all. So why I am doing this, I will tell you in a bit. So now just for this, I will rub this portion and I will do the time complexity analysis. So now here let's see, here this condition I have already taken. So when there is one element, this is 0, the time complexity is 0. When there is two elements, there are two elements, the time complexity is 1. And otherwise, when it is greater than 2, the number of elements greater than 2, So when number of elements greater than 2, this is coming, see, T of n by 2, T of n by 2 plus 1 plus 1. So like this it is coming. So now we will try to do the time complexity analysis here. So what we generally do with the help of this, we just do order of n. It is coming order of n, but we can, so but we are doing the long process here, 2t n by 2 plus 2. So here we are substituting again the recursively, okay. So here 2t n by 2 square plus 2, oh sorry, here it is plus 2, then 2. So now here we can see this 2 square t of n by 2 square, then 2 square plus 2. So it can go on like this, 2 to the power k minus 1 t of n by 2 to the power k minus 1, 2 to the power k minus 2, like this. So here I just did some mistake. So here you can see if it is k 2 to the power k minus 1, this will be also 2 to the power k minus 1. How it is coming? See, 2 to the power 2, and here it is also 2 to the power 2, like this. So now if we take 2 to the power k is equals to n, okay. So now you can put it here, okay. Put let's say this. So here, let me see here. So now t of n by 2 to the power k minus 1, let's see it's visible or not. Yes, it's visible. So here, so now we can say n means what, 2 to the power k. So t of 2 to the power k by 2 to the power k minus 1. So t of 2 to the power k, this coming upside k minus plus minus minus plus, so this is coming as t of 2. We know t of when t of n is equals to 1, so this is coming as 2 to the power k minus 1 dot 1 plus 2 to the power k minus 1, like this. Where is the duster? So now we are simplifying it like this, okay. So now this is coming as her GP series, 2 common 2 to the power k minus 1 minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. So 2 to the power k minus 1, 2 into 2 to the power k, actually let's see, 2 to the power k minus 2, this is coming like this. So 2 to the power k minus 1, k is n, this is n, minus 2, this is n by 2, because 2 to the power k is equals to n. So this is coming as 3n divided by 2 minus 2. So why I did all this, because you can just say that it is order of n, but since I have seen gate questions are asked from like this, question was asked like this, I have seen some questions and in some test series also this question is asked. So directly you are doing all this in just your exam is hectic, so you should have a practice about all this. So how to do this, this may take some time, because what we are actually we do actually just put the master's theorem or iteration or something and just take out this. Yes, it is coming as order of n, so remembering this is a bit tough. So it's I don't know, but if you can remember it, it's good. If you cannot, you can just derive it also, it's nothing much about it. So I will see the question which was asked. So just somewhere you can put it in your wall or something, that 3n by 2 minus 1 is the time needed. So the time complexity, the it's coming down to as order of n. I will see the gate question. So I hope you have understood this. If you haven't, please rewatch the video or you can tell me, okay. So now let's see this question. This was asked in GATE 2007 2 marks question. It was about max and min. So why I was doing all this and telling you to remember this, you can see here. Not remember, but anyways, if you can remember, it's good. For me, it's remembering is very tough. I used to do all these things. So if you can, it's good. Let's see the question now. An array of 8 numbers is given where n is an even number. The max as well as mean of this n numbers needs to be determined. So we have to find max and mean. It's the same algorithm we have seen. So we have to find the max and mean, but here options are different. Okay, so which of the following is true about the comparisons needed? Okay, so generally order of n and all we find, but here it is seen like this: at least 2n minus c comparisons for some constant c, at most 1.5 minus 2 comparisons required, at least n log n comparisons required. See, you can just cross it out because n log n is not required. You can just see that it is order of n, but between these two, and none of this is also there. So between these two, so we have if after evaluation of this, we can see that it is 3n by 2 means 1.5n minus 2. Okay, so this is also wrong. This is our correct option. So at most 1.5n minus 2 comparisons required. So I have seen this question before. That's why I told you. So this is important answer here. So that's why I did the question now. So I will do other gate questions after doing the algorithms first, then I will do the gate questions. Okay, so keep on watching, and for gate questions you have to wait for some time because I have to finish all the algorithms. See, if I can do with algorithms, it's also good, but I want to make a separate video of PYQs because I always prefer doing the algorithms first, understanding everything, and then doing the problems after the algorithms are over. Okay, so because in some questions it will be like insertion sort, merge sort, it will be jumbled up. So it's better to know the algorithms first and then do the question. So if you just know insertion sort and you just go directly, there will be the different algorithms will be mixed and all. So now MCQ, MSQs are also there. So it is for me it was hectic. So I did the algorithms first completely. Like divide and conquer I did whole, then I did the PYQs like this. So I will continue the way I studied. I will do the videos in that way only. I hope this helps, and if not, do tell me. And if you like watching my videos, please do subscribe. Thank you.